Hello, I'm Dave Caldwell with your SUV News Break for Wednesday, November 26th. Just in time for the holiday shopping rush, the FBI is reminding parents about a digital app that might help prevent a child abduction or missing kid amid the mall madness. Using a special tab on the app, you can also quickly and easily email the information to authorities and the media. The owner of the Santa Clarita Motel is planning to build a 42-room hotel in the heart of Old Town Newhall. The 2- and 3-story Luxon Hotel Newhall will take up about a half acre of area at the northwest corner of Railroad Avenue and 5th Street across from Newhall Ice. Its architectural style is described as a hybrid of Western, Victorian, and Main Street commercial consistent with the city's vision for the area. The developer, Icon Hospitality Group, says the hotel conforms with the downtown Newhall specific plan, so it doesn't need further approval by the Planning Commission. However, it still needs to go through plan check and pull permits before construction can begin. County Supervisor Michael Deontonovich plans to appoint Supervisor-elect Hilda Solis as Chair Pro Tem, or Vice Chair, on Tuesday when he's scheduled to take the helm as Los Angeles County Mayor. As chairman of the county's Board of Supervisors, Antonovich becomes the de facto mayor of Los Angeles County. No announcement to that effect has been made, but next Tuesday's published agenda lists him as mayor. Antonovich is entering his final 2 years in office. Southern California remains under a red flag warning with the fire danger considered very high. Forest Service officials would like to caution Santa Clarita Valley residents from traveling through Angeles National Forest and want to remind campers and hikers that open wood and charcoal fires are permitted only in developed campgrounds and picnic areas where a steel fire ring and grills are provided. Strike teams of engines and extra fire prevention patrols from Northern California have been positioned throughout Southern California. Two events were held at Six Flags Magic Mountain Tuesday night, one to show the construction made on Twisted Colossus, and the second to give a sneak peek at Holiday in the Park. Colossus was officially closed August 17th of this year after officials announced their plan to reinvent the nearly 40-year-old coaster. Construction crews are currently working on the first of 3 phases for the ride. The phases include adding a zero-G section and adding lifts to the iconic coaster. This holiday season, the park will be open with 4 areas of the park decked out in holiday decorations, all with their own theme. Holiday in the Park is scheduled to run November 28th to January 4th. For more information about the ride and the new Winterland, visit hometownstation.com. Well, if you're in the mood for a little bit of high school football this holiday weekend, SCV TV has you covered. Our annual Thanksgiving football marathon kicks off Thanksgiving morning at 7 and last through Sunday night. Our entire season of Foothill League action will be played back to back to back to back to back, you get it. This year's marathon schedule is posted online at scvtv.com/sports. Turning to weather, daytime temperatures topped out in the 80s in Santa Clarita Wednesday. Skies will remain clear overnight with lows dropping into the 40s. Warm weather is in the forecast over the next few days, topping out at 84 degrees Thanksgiving Day. Those highs are expected to return to the low 70s by the weekend. That's all for now. For more Santa Clarita news, log on to hometownstation.com or scvnews.com. And all of us here at SCV TV and SCV News wish you and your family a happy Thanksgiving. Thanks for watching. I'm Dave Caldwell.